A man's sexuality is a double-edged sword. It is his greatest source of motivation, while also having the potential to be his number one downfall. Men will appeal to authority and will appeal to consensus and claim they believe in massive, institutionally backed lies so that they don't look, quote, crazy. And this is in order to retain potential opportunities for them to spread their genes, or at the very least, to shoot their seed. And women will believe in anything they're told, as long as it's presented to them under the framework of emotion. They will actually pretend to believe in a lie, even when they know it's a lie, so long as that lie benefits themselves and continues to be of benefit to their group. However, once a man gets older and no longer requires the validation of the GPV, he will start to actually be logical about the reality around him and will come to understand that most of the things he has been taught to believe in his life are massive lies. Women tend to desire the upholding of many such lies in order to control the behaviors of men. You see, men are seen by most women as little more than useful tools. Genetically, women are forced to pursue safety and predictability, and men are merely the horses that they will ride upon the backs of in order to obtain such safe and predictable outcomes for the sake of their own well-being. Therefore, the acceptance of cancel culture and the perverse illusion of progressivism under which we all suffer will continue to thrive within the environment that is created by the worship of the GPV. This is why the education system is so obnoxiously emboldened on their quest to memory hole real truths about the world and about life. Truths that our young have every right to be taught. Because isn't it funny how the institution we know as the education system are the ones who scream the loudest for the normalization of the utterly self-destructive trends that are destroying our society? All of the shit that these institutions need the ignorant young to believe in require a blank slate. The more truths that the beast system can memory hole, the less our vulnerable young will ever even be able to know about in the first place. The idiotic and self-destructive institution of multiculturalism, for example, is merely a manipulation of the Adamic man by proxy. Adamic women know, deep down, that the non-Adamics are a cancer to our civilization. They know that all of Western civilization's problems stem from the coddling of these horrible monsters. Yet, their desire to force Adamic men into the coddling of these beasts does nothing but reinforce a misguided cultural expectation of undeserved compassion for such parasites. And in reality, this is exactly what they themselves are, for the most part. Yes, there are exceptions, but they are few and far between. However, it is still beneficial for women to perpetuate such cultural mythologies, as they are hive-minded creatures and are always attempting to secure safety nets for themselves. Grand deceptions, like big science and the education system that perpetuates the lies of big science, foster opportunities for the creation of men who will then enjoy powerful positions in life due to such lies. Flat earthers, for example, have been pointing out for years now the fact that anyone who has benefited from these institutions of deception are never going to admit that their entire career has been a lie, because then all of the monetary benefits and social status they have reaped from such lies would disappear. Therefore, the women that seek to parasite off of such men are always going to go out of their way to make sure that these institutions of deception continue to thrive, because they will benefit from them by proxy.